क्वेश्चन नंबर 12, सचिन्स मदर इंस्ट्रक्टेड हिम टू रिटर्न होम बाय ट्रेन इफ इट रेन्स हैविली, सो शी इज गिविंग इंस्ट्रक्शन टू हर चाइल्ड, हर सन सचिन, सो इफ इट रेन्स हैविली देन कम बाय ट्रेन. Assumption 1, Sachin may not be able to decide himself if it rains heavily. So as per the given statement, so mother is giving a suggestion. She is not doubting that Sachin will not be able to decide, or he is not in a position to decide. So this assumption is not implicit. So as per given statement, it is an advice by mother to her son, and there is no assumption that Sachin is not able to decide. So assumption 1 is not implicit. Second assumption, the train may ply even if it rains heavily. Yes, this assumption is right, because when it is raining heavily, other transportation may systems stop, but her mother is assuming that train will still be plying, or will be running. Plying means running. So in heavy rain, generally, all transports stop, but trains still work or ply. So the assumption 2 is implicit. So only assumption 2 is implicit, 1 is not, so answer is B. Question number 13, please put more people on the job to make up for the delay. So someone is saying to other person that put more people on the job to make up the delay. It means that work or that project is getting delayed. That's why he is more worried about it. So that's why he is planning to put more people. Assumption 1, delay is inevitable in most jobs. This is a general statement. This is a general assumption which do not apply. So this must be happening only for a specific work or specific project. It cannot be applied to all work. They all work, do not delay. So as per given statement, delay is happening to that specific task or work, and it cannot be assumed to be happening with all task or work. So assumption 1 is not implicit. Assumption 2, output will increase with more number of people on the job. Yes, assumption is right, because putting more people will make the work go faster and that delay can be avoided. Yes, with more people, more work, and the chances of delaying the work can be avoided. So assumption 2 is implicit. So our answer is B. Question number 14, if you are an engineer, we have a challenging job for you. So someone is looking for engineer, that's why he is asking to the other person, if you are an engineer, we have a work for you. So assumption one, we need an engineer. Definitely, as per statement, they are looking for engineer. So as per statement, someone is looking for engineer. So assumption one is implicit. And also as per assumption one, he is assuming that you are an engineer, but it is not true that you are an engineer. You may not be. So as per statement, someone is expecting the person on other side to be engineer to take up the job, but it is not implied that other person is engineer. So assumption 2 is not implicit. So only assumption 1 is implicit. So answer is